To snozzberries, keeping the attention of your teenagers tougher than ever.
Well, how do I get them to put their phones down?
Like this. We want Mashiach now!
This one goes out to all the emails and the apples.
Hey!
Shake it like a Shabbos! Facebook?
No!
Twitter?
No!
Instagram is like that! Put your phone down!
Skokie's annual Cteen Gala. Welcome all the honorees who are here tonight, all the teens of Cteen. Welcome Cteen honoree Ronen Lavi and his family and friends. Welcome Cteen Junior honoree Jesse Goldberg and his family and friends. Welcome Cteen parents, welcome friends, donors, welcome Cteen alums. Welcome, I'm so happy to see everybody here in person. And you know what? A little rain doesn't make a difference. Would you rather be on Zoom? No. Would you rather be wet? Yes. That's right. Smart people here. That's the Cteen spirit. Well, let's begin with the Cteen anthem.
A proud one too, as bright as day, it's my DNA. So shout out loud, my Cteen crowd, a family forever will be. The summer Jew, a proud one too, as bright as day, it's my DNA.
About the market, my Jewish pride's forever rocking. The only Jew in my whole grave, I've got a soul that he's got made. I said a C, a T, an E, an E, and an N. Say it again. I said a C, a T, an E, an E, and an N.
Cteen crowd, a family forever will be.
Chief Justice Posner, as we like to call him, has been a resident of Skokie for more years than you can count on your fingers and toes. I mean, that's a lot of years. His achievements are many. His heirs are few. Rabbi, we're ready for you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rabbi Yosef Posner.
With the screen knocked out my speech. So I will just suffice with greeting everyone. Thank you very much for coming, for being here, for supporting Cteens. Congratulations to the honorees. I've just mentioned that it's appropriate, the Torah portion for this week is Baaloskas and Eres, when you kindle the menorah. The Jewish people is compared to a menorah with many branches, and the Torah uses the word for kindling, uses the word Baaloska, which means not just to kindle it, but to make sure that the flame burns brightly before moving on to the next one. And that's exactly what Cteens does. Cteens takes Jewish kids and makes sure, Baaloska, makes sure that each gives individual attention to each one, making sure that that little flame grows into a big, mature, bright flame. And through all of the branches of our Cteen menorah, we'll light up the world and bring the whole world ready for the coming of Mashiach now. Okay.
Professor Velvel Green was a scientist at NASA, an exobiologist who looked for microbes in space. He would often talk to the Rebbe about his work. The Rebbe once shared an important lesson from space travel. To slip the surly bonds of Earth and launch a rocket into space, an immense amount of fuel was needed. But to hold all that fuel, the rocket needs a giant tank. And to lift the weight of that giant tank, you need even more fuel. So now you need an even bigger container. And it goes on. Scientists were at a loss. And the way the scientists solved this conundrum, the Rebbe exclaimed, can teach us all a lesson in how to serve God. The scientists created the Saturn rocket, a multi-stage rocket made of detachable parts. The biggest fuel tank does the heavy lifting. Once that tank has served its purpose, it's now dead weight, so it's jettisoned, and the rocket leaves it behind. The lighter rocket continues to be propelled forward by the next tank. When that tank is used up, it detaches as well. This three-stage design is what allowed astronauts to leave Earth's gravity and finally reach space. And what can this teach us? The Torah tells us, educate the child according to his way. Education can't remain stagnant, but must grow with the child. When a kid is little, you may offer him candy or other trifles as an incentive. When he gets older, his desires are less petty. Perhaps the incentive is a bike. When he matures more, reaching adulthood, his goals and incentives change as well. You wouldn't offer a grown-up candy. What propelled him forward in his youth is now dead weight, holding him back from his goals. Every day is a new day, and our goals must be set higher, and the path to get there must grow accordingly. When our goals grow with us, we can blast off to the stars.
As a longtime friend of Chabad and the Posners, Mayor Van Dusen has perfected the art of the mayoral speech. Don't forget to quote your dad, because dad advice is always relevant, but stay on point. Ladies and gentlemen, Mayor Van Dusen!
Thank you so much. I didn't realize I lost that much hair. It's truly a pleasure to be with you. The last time I was with you, Rabbi was reminding me it was by Zoom with my granddaughter at Hanukkah. What a time we've passed through. I was asking myself this afternoon, what do you say when you're going to the very first large gathering with friends in almost 14 months? And it's welcome. It is so great to be with you, rain or shine. But I think this past 14 months or so really shows the essence of what the Cteen program is really all about. We've all been challenged over these last 14 months.
but it's about leadership. And I want to specially come here tonight to thank my friends, the Posners. It's such a pleasure to be the mayor of a great town like Skokie. We've been challenged. First, we were the first community to mandate the use of masks. And it was controversial. There were some people, understandably, who didn't agree with my decision. I think in the end it worked because, in spite of disagreeing with me, everybody really did gather together and we marched along the same path because we have the same goal in mind. And that is the betterment of each and every one of us. And the teams here tonight have learned a lesson about the essence and the importance of leadership. And I want to thank you, the parents, the Posners, and all of you who have contributed to making Cteen so great. My congratulations to the honorees and their families. This evening is dedicated to all of you. Thank you so much for letting me be with you. I look forward to many, many more gatherings like this one. Be well, everybody. Thank you.
For hundreds, maybe even thousands of years, scholars from across the globe have debated the pronunciation of... I don't know how to pronounce it. Just roll the tape.
Gala.
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 Gal.
Gala.
These are gala apples.
What'd you say?
Gala apples. When you're talking about an event, it's a gala, but the apples are gala apples.
Gala apples.
Are you going to the gala?
I'm going to the gala.
No, this is the gala.
What about Grace? Is Grace?
No, sorry.
Gala. Gala.
Gala.
Nobody calls it the Met Gala. It's the gala.
Thank you.
Gala.
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 I say gala.
Cteen Gala.
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 It's gala.
Gala. Duh.
Gala.
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 Say gala.
Gala.
When this person commits to something, she goes all the way! Dr. Zavell stands up for Jewish students at Niles North. Thanks to her devotion, the Jewish club at Niles North is thriving! She'll even dance in a tree costume if that's what it takes! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Ann Zavell!
So we all know how to say it now, right?
Gala.
Everybody agrees?
Gala.
Okay, very good. So good evening. I'm Dr. Ann Zavell, and I'm the faculty sponsor of the Niles North Jewish Association of Students, which the students have dubbed Jew Crew. I want to take this opportunity to first thank Rabbi Posner and Rebbetzin Posner for keeping the club going all year. For real. Their creative programming allowed us to continue to meet 10 times via Zoom, even enjoying a delicious lunch together every single time delivered to our doors. Each club meeting focused on a central theme, such as Rosh Hashanah Remix, Thanksgiving, Hanukkah Unboxed, Super Jew, The Hero in You, Tu B'Shvat, I did not dress up this time. No. Purim, that's a wrap. Happiness, Escape from Egypt, an interactive escape room adventure. And is prophecy, fantasy, or reality? And the last one was Lag BaOmer. And without them, seriously, the club wouldn't have been able to continue to be there for the kids during the quarantine. So thank you. However, this is the serious side of the night. Rabbi has asked me to share with you that while we are celebrating Cteen and Cteen Junior tonight, and congratulations, honorees, it is also important that I share with you the other side of the club. As the faculty sponsor of the club, I have also become the unofficial voice of the Jewish faculty and students whom district administration look to when anti-Semitic events occur in our schools. After the school email system was hacked this fall, which included anti-Semitic content and Jewish teachers from both Niles North and Niles West felt their voices were being unheard, I organized a Jewish teachers affinity group. Sadly, we have had to meet several times, and while not everyone agrees on politics, we do agree that anti-Semitism is on the rise in our schools. In April, we met with both principals and the acting superintendent to discuss our concerns. And this month, an administrator reached out and invited me to participate in a dialogue with the sponsor of the Niles West Muslim Student Association Club, sponsor, who had used the district email to share politically minded email from his students. As we move forward to address these issues affecting our students and greater community, I invite you to join Rabbi Posner and me in a conversation on how to proactively address the fears of our Jewish families. I am happy to discuss this with any of you who wish to discuss the current situation in District 219 and our community in general. Just let Rabbi know and he will connect us. I'm grateful to Alon and Jack for this year for working so hard to keep the club going, as it is clearly needed more than ever. So thank you again, Rabbi and Rabbitson, for partnering with me. We are not only providing a fun learning Jewish space for our students, but we are demystifying Judaism for the diverse population in Niles North and creating a space for important dialogue addressing anti-Semitism in the district. Thank you.
I'm gonna guess a pink fidget toy.
A pink fidget toy? Does it feel pink?
I'm getting that vibe, that it's pink.
You're getting a pink vibe from it?
I think so.
All right.
A stress ball?
Man, what is this thing that I'm touching? Ew, it's squishy. It's like a squishy thing, and it's like, it could be like a in a bed, or it could be like a squishy pet, or like a, ew, it feels like it could be like, it feels like it could be like a, has like a belly button in it, or like an ear. It's kind of cool though, not gonna lie, it's pretty cool, man.
Maybe like a seat cushion?
Pretend hollow.
Pretend hollow?
Yes.
Like a pillow that's, doesn't, not a pillow I would want to sleep on. There's pizza on the box. There's red dots. Makes me think that it's either an apple or a cherry. So those are red.
A squishy. A squishy? I don't know. Is it like some kind of squishy? It feels kind of like a cake.
All right, so for your final answer?
A squishy.
A squishy.
A squishy.
A squishy.
Yeah.
Squishy gala apple.
Like a part of a dodgeball? Pumpkin maybe? Like a couch cushion?
Peach.
A car seat headrest cushion.
It's like one of those squishy things.
Is that the technical term? One of those squishy things?
You think I know the technical term? This is fun. I really want to see what it is now.
I don't know. So what's your guess? I don't know.
So, you come here often? Yeah, every now and then. Not a human belly, like a pregnant belly of a monkey. Not a monkey. Maybe an orangutan.
All right.
Anytime?
Anytime. You're good?
I'm gonna just stand here.
That's it?
It's an animal.
I don't know. I don't know what it is.
I don't feel prepared already.
I don't know.
He's like one of those squishy stress toys.
Wait, I smell something. So it's like scented maybe? You're giving me a COVID test. Yeah, it smells like something. So I definitely think it's like a dessert.
It's like some kind of stress toy?
So that's my guess. A squishy, big squishy toy that's like a food of some sort.
All right, and for the big reveal, here we go!
Y'all ready for this? All right.
Hey!
Oh! It is a squishy. Big squishy. Watermelon squishy.
It's a squishy.
Give it up for everyone's favorite young rabbi! He's the one who keeps Cteen together and the Cteen band from falling apart! He's a man of many hats with one signature dance move, Rabbi Yochanan Posner!
What a special year for Skokie Cteen! What an amazing year! Yes, there were limits due to Corona, but magically, as time went on, those things became opportunities for growth. We jettisoned the limits and soared higher than ever this year. I remember how I felt when we canceled our first Cteen event due to the lockdown in March of 2020. A week passed. We hadn't seen the teens for a week. I began to wonder, is life over? Will I ever see human beings again? Will I ever see Cteen again? Would Cteen stop being a family because we can't get together? What will happen? But out of that despair came amazing creativity. Yona perfected the art of the Zoom. And instead of losing ground, many new people joined Cteen this year. There are so many people here tonight who've become friends over Zoom, and we're seeing them the first time tonight. I'm so happy to see everybody. Instead of drifting apart, this year we actually came closer together. Corona gave us the opening to do crazy things that nobody would ever even think about. We introduced the Village of Skokie to the idea of a drive-in theater as a safe way to gather during Corona. We painted a mural. As far as I know, this is the only Jewish public art display in Skokie, Illinois, Midwest. I'm not sure how far you have to go for another piece of community-made Jewish public art. This year, we launched Cteen U. Dozens of high schoolers studied Torah in a relevant and meaningful way and earned high school credits for it. When so many clubs became inactive and the building was not open to students, Jew Crew was open and thriving. When our usual chesed organizations weren't allowing in volunteers, we couldn't go to Maot Chittim or to the Ark. So we created our own chesed organization. We rolled out Better Together, which provided a structured way for teens to be social with elderly and sharing joy all around. We delivered literally thousands of packages this year. But what's important isn't the physical package. What's important is the feelings that were delivered inside the package. Warmth, friendship, society, normalcy, happiness was lovingly packed by Yona in each and every single package. And that is what Cteen's all about. It's not an organization, it's not a building. Cteen is a group of friends who like each other. There's two adults, and the rest are teens. Beautiful, happy, nice, pleasant, adorable Jewish teens. And friendship is not stopped by Corona. my dear Cteeners, for your friendship. It means so much to Yona and to myself. I want to thank Brett Walko and Elizabeth for making the amazing production tonight. We thank Chris for the mechanics of it. We thank Brian and Milt for the delicious food. Thank you. Thank you to our amazing Cteen leaders, because they're the ones who are really responsible for Cteen. Thank you, Yona Posner, for being the creative genius who continues to gush forth continuously with more and new creative ideas. Yona, maybe you didn't realize it, but your calling finally found you. And Isabel, thank you for being the great defender of Jewish values at District 219. Thank you to the Cteen Gala Parent Committee for tonight's event under the leadership of Rachel Jakowski. Rachel embodies the saying that once in Cteen, always in Cteen. Rachel is a lifer. I'd like to ask all of the parent committee to come forth. This gala wouldn't happen without you. So Mitchell, Natasha Goldberg, Jacob and Rachel Jakowski, Sharon and Hugh Lavi, don't be shy. You don't get a choice, step right up. Onto the platform. David and Tammy Miller, there's seltzer here, David, for you, if you could just come on up. But all the parents here. You know, all the parents here, with your seltzer, man. We have the ideal gift for you. It's your very own Cteen cookie jar. Because every parent of teens needs to eat cookies. As the saying goes, life is like a box of cookies. But when you're a Cteen parent, all the cookies in the jar are your favorites. So, with the photographer, everyone coming up, don't be shy. Okay, one pair of cookies for every couple. One pair of cookies. Okay, you got your cookies?
There you go.
Okay, come on up. Tammy, we need you up here. You're so short.
You're gonna write the photo.
You're so short already. Come on. David, come on up. There's seltzer in your future. Come on. Okay, everyone smile for the camera. All right. Great. I want to thank Chaya Mishalovin, who was one of our great behind-the-scenes secrets that made those deliveries happen so seamlessly and so flawlessly. We even made sure that the Copeland squirrels didn't eat their packages.
Ah, I see Jack has joined us in the Zoom. So hello, Jack. Hello to Zach, and hello to Haley, and hello to Ronan. I see everyone has brought their pets today. That's lovely. Yona's not here yet, so let's start off with the question. What's your favorite color? And everyone, remember the question, because I don't want to have to repeat it 7 times. Don't be that guy. All right, so the first person on my screen is Haley. Let's start with you.
I don't know if you come back to me.
Okay, sure. Jack?
Wait, did you ask for our favorite food?
No, I asked for your favorite color.
Oh, in that case, pizza, definitely.
Okay, great. Zach, could you turn on your camera? We'd love to see you.
Blue.
Ronan, what about you?
Oh man, did I miss it again? Hey everyone!
So, what are we making today?
We're making a pretty simple recipe.
Are they frozen for everyone?
Yes.
I think the internet's broken again.
We can hear you now.
Oh look, it's working again.
Where did I cut out?
I don't remember.
Well, in case you didn't hear it, we're making... First, we have our egg. We have our bowl. We have our flour. We have our oil. We have our jam. And we have a fork. Okay, now we're gonna add the egg. So first we have to check for blood. So I have 3 cups. So I'm gonna crack the egg. What you do is you crack it on the counter. Then you put your thumb in it.
Wait, can you go back? I forgot how to crack the egg.
I'll show it again. You take the egg, you crack it on the corner of your counter. You take your cup, you put your 2 thumbs in it, and you crack it. Then you pour it into your bowl. Now you're gonna grab your dough.
Wait, mine doesn't look like that. Did I do something wrong?
Yeah, it looks fine.
That looks so nice. Make sure to send pictures in the group chat.
Okay, everyone should grab their pan. You're gonna preheat. You should have preheated your oven to 350. You're gonna put it in here for about 15 minutes. Now we're done with the cooking, so let's go back to Rabbi and play some games. We're gonna take out the game that I got from a targeted ad on Facebook, which is a Cupid's.
Oh, this toy, I love these.
I broke mine already.
Make sure to send pictures in the group chat.
Are we doing anything else tonight?
Nope. But I have to go put my kids to sleep. So have a good night, guys.
Everyone say bye to Yona. All right, guys.
Bye, Yona.
So you know what I always say. You guys are welcome to stay as long as you like. However, the event is officially over. That's right.
Oh, wait.
That's right. This is
which is a Cupid's.
Cupid's.
You are not putting that in the dark.
That's going in the bloopers.
What is this called?
A Rubik's Cube.
A Rubik's Cube.
Now it's time to install the new leaders for this coming year. The student leaders for Association of Jewish Students this year are Jack Copeland, Alon Sepiashvili, and new for this year, Anna Copeland. Skokie Cteen overall is led by a teen leadership board. President Ronen Lavi and the current board are now officially completing this year's term of leadership. Thank you for your devoted service. It's time to announce the Cteen board for the coming year. Please welcome Cteen President Jack Copeland. Jack is reliable, works hard, is confident in his Jewishness, and most importantly, and this is why Jack will be a great president, Jack is always eager to grow and learn and stretch himself to reach the next level. Please welcome Cteen leader Reva Weiss. Reva brings persistence, focus, tirelessness, and devotion. Please welcome Cteen leader Zach Miller. Zach brings eagerness, humility, gentleness, and caring. Please welcome Cteen leader Haley Galtz. Haley brings sparkle, vivaciousness, energy, and friendliness. Please welcome Cteen leader Tali Weiss. Tali brings enthusiasm, cheerfulness, adventurousness, and just the right kind of goofiness that Cteen needs. Jack, Reva, Zach, Haley, Tali, we look forward to working with all of you this year to create an amazing, amazing Cteen experience for all the teens this year. We know that you're gonna go the distance and that you're gonna travel to any length to make Cteen a success this year. And you'll bring that Jewish pride, that Cteen spirit, that warmth wherever you go. And so, we have the ideal gifts for you. Your very own Cteen thermoses to keep your own soup hot so you can fulfill all of the cups of all of your peers with hot, delicious, warm Cteen soup of Torah and mitzvahs. And now we smile for the picture.
One, two, three.
This boyish engineer is repping Jewish pride with his Jew crew. He's a founding member of the Jewish Club at Niles North and has been known to wear some pretty strange things to school. Meanwhile, look at that kippah! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Jack Copeland!
Good evening. Congrats to Ronen and Jesse, the honorees. Woo! I'm a rising senior at Niles North, and I've been on the Cteen Leadership Board since my freshman year. I've had the privilege to serve under several great presidents, Sarah Weiss, Woo! Nathan Shapiro and Woo! Haley Jakovsky, and most recently, Ronen Lavi. You are my role models, and you've taught me so much. I'm excited to apply these leadership skills in my new role as president this year, and to teach them to a new generation of Cteen leaders. This year was certainly a challenging one because of Corona, but Cteen did not stop. As a matter of fact, Cteen did more this year than ever before. How did we do it? Well, it was a team effort. Lots of credit goes to you, the teens of Cteen. You took a big step this year by being adventurous and participating in a completely new and different form of Cteen programming. I also want to give credit to this amazing board. Ronen, Reva, Zach, and Haley. You are the most hardworking and most creative people ever. Rabbi and Yona, your support and guidance means so much to us. Cteen is led by us youth, but you provide the foundation for us to grow and expand. Together, we adapted to the new reality and Cteen thrived. The things we did together are incredibly inspiring, and everyone here should be very proud. I'm excited for the opportunity to lead this amazing group. As we move out of Corona, we will not return to normalcy. We will move to bigger and better. Yeah. I'm eager to work with the new board to plan more in-person events, more trips, more Torah learning, more Shabbat dinners, and more good times with our signature cozy Cteen feel.
We hope to bring even more teens into the Cteen family to experience the joy and warmth of Cteen. I'm excited to work alongside Reva, Zach, Haley, and Tali as we bring Cteen to even greater heights than we could have ever imagined. As president of Cteen, I want to be in touch with all the teens of Cteen. I want you to know that I'm accessible and available to you. Even if we don't go to the same school, or we're not in the same grade, or we weren't friends before we met at Cteen, I want you to know that I want to be real friends with you. Let's be awesome together. We ask Hashem for success in our efforts this year, and I'm honored that you've entrusted me with this important responsibility. Thank you.
The Torah kept strong, and the Torah will never disappear. When all you see is night, just remember you are light. Uplift a friend, they'll make you smile. I'm a Jew and I'm proud, and I'll sing it out loud, 'cause forever that's what I'll be. I'm a Jew and I'm proud, and it's without a doubt, Hashem is always watching over me. I'm a Jew and I'm proud, and I'll sing it out loud with my brothers and sisters from Cteen. I'm a Jew and I'm proud, and it's without a doubt, Hashem is always watching over me. Hashem shomer alai. Hashem siempre está protegiéndome.
Me.
And now I get to talk about Jesse Goldberg. Tonight's Cteen Junior honoree. You see, I used to know Jesse as Rachel and Zachary's little brother. He would show up now and then when the siblings were coming or going. I was like, hey, he's the little brother. That's what I thought. But then the day came that Jesse was old enough to attend Cteen Junior. And I was like, wow, that kid is really something. And I really began to get Jesse's vibe when he began studying Torah as Cteen Junior's essentials. And I realized that Jesse is embodying everything we're teaching at Cteen. In a sense, Jesse is Cteen and Cteen is Jesse. Jesse creates his own atmosphere. Jesse doesn't wait for others to set the mood. Jesse doesn't try to be what the others are. Jesse doesn't try to fit in other people's vibes. Jesse makes the vibe that those people want to be part of. And Jesse makes the vibe by thoughtfully sensing what other people might be needing at the moment. And this is what the Rebbe says in Hayoyim Yoyim. And I quote, the Rebbe says, a chassid creates an environment. And Jesse does that by being cheerful and kind and devoted to Torah. Some people think that you have to be mean or put people down to be popular. Or they think that you can't be religious if you want to be with it. Or they think that you have to be bossy if people will do things for you. And some people even think they don't matter. But those people don't know what Jesse knows. Jesse shows us all the power of cheerfulness, kindness, inclusiveness, attentiveness, and how all that's really simply a part of Jewishness and holiness. That's the message of Cteen, and that's why Jesse is being honored here tonight. We're honoring Jesse tonight because we want all the teens present here tonight to emulate Jesse's important traits. We want everyone to know you can do it too. So, let's welcome Jesse Goldberg.
This wee laddie brings the quirk into every smirk. He was even the photographer at his own bar mitzvah. Yes, Jesse's bright smile and humor keeps things fresh at Cteen Junior. And guess what? Here he is now, Jesse Goldberg!
Last night, Jesse sent me a photo of a bird. And I said to myself, I like how Jesse saw the beauty in something so common and so mundane as a regular bird. And then I said to myself, you know, I wish I could see the world through Jesse's lenses. Anyway, to support Jesse's hobby of photography, we hereby present you with the perfect camera case. This will keep your lenses clean, cheerful, and holy. Wow. Jesse, knock him dead.
According to Cteen custom, you have to put this on your forehead. Hello! First of all, I want to say thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you, Rabbi and Yona Posner, for making Cteen and Cteen Junior possible. Thank you to my mom and dad for letting me go to Cteen Junior. Thank you to Rachel and Zachary, my siblings, for giving me help when I need it the most. Like when I fail on projects during Zoom. It all began in the year of 2017. I was a wee lad and knew that my sister Rachel every Monday went to this place called Cteen. So I asked if I could go to pick her up with my mom. My mom said, sure, but stay in the car. When we got to Cteen, I asked if I could get out. My mom said, Why not? She let me go by myself. And I went into the moose. It was so cool. There were people eating, playing, and talking everywhere. There's even grass on the walls. But everything went silent except for the wee. All the faces were looking at me. And Rachel went up to me and said, "This is Cteen. Would you want to join?" And I said, "But isn't Cteen for teens?" And Rabbi came up to me and said, "You know, there's something called Cteen Junior. Would you want to go to that?" I was so excited that I asked for a panini. When we got to the car, I told my mom what happened to me, and she said I could go to Cteen Junior. So that next Tuesday, I went to Cteen Junior. I was kind of shy at first, but everybody was super welcoming. The next week, I was doing everything I could to stay there. It was so fun. So as 2 years of Tuesdays came by, I was happier and happier. I was also sometimes the helper Cteen Junior person, helping clean up and things like that. And then COVID hit. Boom, everything changed. Schools closing, people out of work, and I realized no Cteen. My brother and sister, Rachel and Zachary, on Monday had Zoom Cteen, so I hoped that we could have Cteen Junior on Zoom. And guess what? We did! It was definitely different than what we usually did, but it was still lots of fun. I was so enthusiastic that I kind of forgot all about COVID. Zoom Cteen Junior is so fun because you get to cook 1 week, then paint the next, and then you get to do both the third week. Every Tuesday, we have a question like, "Do you like rain? And if you do, why?" I almost come up with the good answers for the question like, "I like rain because rain rains for the people who like rain raining." I always go to Cteen Junior when I can, and if I can't, I'm sad. But I cheer up because next Tuesday is 7 days away. And I am looking forward to going to Cteen Junior on Tuesday next week. I'm pretty sure there's Cteen. And soon, Cteen in a few years.
History's greatest inventions. They improve our lives. Recently, a monumental discovery has occurred that will change the family dining dynamic forever. Soup in a cup. Remix!
Soup in a cup.
Soup in a cup.
Not soup in a bowl, cause that's lame.
Soup in a cup, 1, 2, 1, 2. That's how many minutes you gotta heat it up. Sometimes you want a snack and you better you escalate.
Have some soup hot and fresh like your bubby made.
Stop with the wrapping, eat while it's hot.
Who wants soup in a bowl?
That's nasty.
We want soup in a cup.
That's classy.
You can drink it, slurp it, gulp it down.
But it better be a cup or you'll look like a clown.
Soup in a cup.
Yay. Yay.
Cups are stylish, portable, don't require utensils. Results
in less spilling.
Plus, it looks great on your resume. Soup in a cup, the only way to eat your soup.
Soup in a bowl is boring and outdated. You should try eating soup in a cup. It's a delicious, fresh new way to eat soup. See, even he likes it.
No. Yeah.
Soup in a cup.
That's how they do it at the Posner House. The Posner House. The Posner House.
Soup in a cup. Not soup in a bowl, cause that's lame.
Skokie Cteen in the house.
Soup in a cup. It's the most awesome thing ever.
Soup in a cup.
Accomplish one thing in this lifetime is people will learn finally how to eat soup.
Yes.
Now, It's my chance to talk about Ronen. Ronen, don't, it won't hurt. So much to say about Ronen. Where do I start? I know Ronen since he was a baby. Actually, dial his number and listen to his message. We've shared so many good times together. So many laughs, so many jokes. Also, so many serious moments of heartfelt conversation and hard work. So let me tell you a bit about Ronen. When we're setting out on a trip or a Shabbaton, and it's early in the morning, and everyone is still groggy and sleepy, and I ask the boys, who wants to daven? Ronen is the guy. Well, they got his talis and his tefillin and daven the full davening. There's a problem which seems unsolvable. Ronen is the guy who will simply come up with a creative answer to the problem. That's Ronen. When there is something important that needs to be done, and it seems that nobody is doing it, Ronen is that reassuring voice in my ear which says, we got this, Rebbe. When people are wasting time and nothing is happening, Ronen is the guy who stays focused on the task. When you want a good conversation with a good friend, Ronan's your guy. And when we need creative new ideas for Cteen kickoff, Angry Birds, Ronen's your guy. When we're in New York for the Shabbaton, and it's Saturday night, and all you want to do is yell and scream with the joy of being a Jew at Cteen, but you're feeling a little inhibited. Ronen's the guy who belts out, Shasha Shavua Tov, Shasha Shavua Tov. When you're on the Cteen road trip and you want to sing loudly with your friends in the Cteen van with the blasting music and the wind rushing through your hair, but you need the right playlist, Ronen's the guy. Out pops his phone and strikes just the right tone. Like I always say, at Cteen with Ronen, I have my own personal DJ. When you're trying to write a rap song and you can't find the words that rhyme and you don't know where to start, ask Ronen. He knows the right guy. So, everybody, let's welcome Ronen Lavi.
Let's hear it for tonight's honoree! From the start, he's been right in the middle of the action. And at the same time, he makes sure to never pass on a good nap. How does he do it? He's got superpowers! Ladies and gentlemen, Ronen Lavi!
Ronen, we have just the perfect gift for you. It's been several years since your bar mitzvah. But in a way, tonight is like a bar mitzvah as well. You're done with high school, done with Ida Crown, you're outgrowing Cteen. The way you live your life is going to change. Up until now, you're living at home with your parents and with your sister in the close embrace of your community. But now you're going to go out into the big world. You're going out of town for school. And in a sense, now you're really a man. A real man carries a pocket knife. Not just to cut physically. Ronen Lavi. Take a look at this. The knife isn't just to cut things physically, but it's a reminder to cut out what's not important and to focus on what matters in life.
Thank you.
Photo.
Okay.
All right. So,
like to start off saying thank you to Rabbi and Yona for the nice gift and obviously for the honor. So a round of applause for them. And I'd also like to thank the board that I've had the pleasure of working with this year. I'd like to say thank you so much, and you guys have really made it easy for me to be president. So, when I first heard about Cteen from Rabbi Yochanan Posner, I was more than a little skeptical. I did not believe that I would fit in or enjoy it, but one Shabbat morning, I decided to ignore my doubts, and I actually walked into the moose. I was pleasantly surprised when I found myself at a table full of teens just like me. Shockingly, I enjoyed it. I felt like I had become part of a happy community of trusted friends, and since then, I've never looked back. When I first started participating in Cteen, I did it because it was fun. However, I actually wound up becoming a better person in a variety of ways. I became a lot more responsible. For example, I learned the value of being on time and to notify others even if you are just a few minutes late. I learned how to look out for others and be aware of their feelings, and to reach out to ensure that everyone is comfortable and enjoying themselves. I learned how to work efficiently with the group, and I became a team player who learned to contribute to the overall success of the entire team. I learned about compromise and that it is important to hear everyone's perspectives in order to come to a real consensus. I learned that time is precious and to choose carefully how I spend my time and to devote time to causes that are important to me, like Cteen. Cteen helped me realize that every Jew is important simply because they are Jewish. It's not about how orthodox one is, it's just about if they are growing and doing more than they did the day before. I traveled to New York for the International Shabbaton 3 times. My experience there and visiting 770 and seeing the people daven with tefillin so early in the morning inspired me and is a big reason why I'm choosing to go to Yeshiva Ashreinu in Beit Shemesh, Israel before I start college in the spring. So my time at Cteen has left me with memories and tools that I will take with me wherever I go. And I look forward to continuing to be a leader for Jewish causes at Tulane, and I've already visited the Chabad house there and feel at home. I am excited to bring what I've learned with me at Cteen to Ashreinu and New Orleans, and I'd like to thank everyone here. Thank you.
Here we are! It's time for Cteen Cafe! Guys?
Is recommending a nationwide lockdown. Stay at home for the next 30 days, starting on Monday.
How are we gonna do Cteen?
Who wants a panini? Who wants a panini?
Panini!
Panini! Who would like a panini? Here you go! Eat up!
Happy birthday, Sarah Wise! Happy birthday, happy birthday! Happy birthday, happy birthday! Happy birthday, happy birthday! Happy birthday, Yona! Happy birthday, birthday! Happy, happy birthday!
No, turn around, turn around, turn around! I promise I'm a better driver in real life. Yes? Yes? Okay, for real. Cut it out. Stop. Done.
Who wants to hear what happened to me today at the hospital? Anybody? Somebody? Hey guys, eat the food, because she's gonna keep making more and more and more.
Yona, jelly beans aren't the answer. No, no, use this technology.
Oh.
Our next speaker has learned to roll with whatever comes along. Between the creative activities and all the trips and all the snacks and all the packages, I bet we all wonder how she keeps everything running. Has she cloned herself? I wonder. Ladies and gentlemen, Yona Posner!
I'm just going to do the fun part of the night, which is drawing the J-Text raffle. And if we can have the leaders come up and help us, they're going to pull the raffle tickets. So I'm just going to, I think everyone here knows what J-Text is, but in case you don't, J-Text is a twice weekly text that gets sent out to any of the kids who are on the J-Text, signed up on the J-Text. It's a Judaic trivia question, and the seventh person to answer correctly wins a $20 Amazon gift card. So that happens all year long. And if you don't know how to sign up for J-Text, this is for teens, turn to your friend next to you and find out how. And when, besides for the chance to win $20 every single Monday and Thursday, we also get points for every time you answer, whether it's correct or incorrect. And tonight we took those points and converted them to raffle tickets, and we have these awesome prizes that anyone who participates in J-Text got to put in for the raffle. So Leva, and you guys, come on up. And right now we are pulling the raffle for the, there's a mini ice cream maker. And Ronen, you wanna pull that out? Just take a card. Oh, okay.
Okay, you wanna read it?
This is Shmuley Lorderman. Woo! You want a personal ice cream maker?
Get on up here, Shmuley.
I'm gonna give you the prizes in a few minutes though, because they're all in one box. Take the next one. You. And the next one is for a giant beanbag. Yours don't mix very well. If you know where the ice cream maker is, you can just hand it right to Shmuley. Okay. Just rub it in there. Okay, and this is for the beanbag. Johan! Woo! Or not. Oops. This one is for sequin pillow. There's a lot to choose from in here.
Yeah, there's a lot of cards. Oh, yeah.
All right.
The sequin pillow. To Zach Miller.
Woo! All right. Okay, and this one is for a giant pack of gel pens. It's like, I don't know, 50, 100, 100 of, I don't know how many, but it's a lot of gel pens. Okay, Tally's got the prize, and let's see who's getting the prize. Okay. You want to read it?
Ethan Marotti.
Is it Ethan Marotti who won the gel pen? Okay. And this is for a $25 Amazon gift card. And we're actually gonna pull two of these.
Two?
Yeah, I have two gift cards.
Wait, but Yona, two different jars.
Oh, there's two different jars? Oh, okay, great. We'll only pull one from this one then. Go ahead. Rachel Adar! Woo! This one is for a $50 Apple gift card. Alright, shake it up there.
Please be me, Zach.
Ethan Marotti.
Oh, wait. Okay. You already won something, so we're gonna pull another.
Thank you.
Sorry, dude.
Kobe Harris.
Kobe Harris. And this is for Crazy Aaron's pack of putties. Three Crazy Aaron's putties. Thank you. Who's pulling this one? Reba. Crazy Aaron's putty. No, that was Ella Tag. Is Ella here? Did she leave? All right. Oh, hi, Ella. Come on up and get it. Come on up. All right. This one is for the laser tag set. It's a laser, four-person laser tag set.
Zachary Goldberg!
Yeah.
This is for...
Here you go.
Oh, this one's really full, guys. Exactly. It's for the Beats headphones. Better be praying right now if your name is in here. So much pressure, totally. All right, go.
Moshe Saruya. Woo!
This is for the hammock. So I don't know if you guys noticed, there's a tiny theme that happened tonight with the gifts that we gave the honorees and the leaders, and it's all about traveling, because after the year that we've had, we really hope that the teens, all of you, go out there and have a lot of adventures this summer in a safe way, of course, but make up for last year's bummer. So this is for the hammock.
Jesse Goldberg.
Jesse. Oh, Jesse. Okay, another $25 Amazon gift card. Those Amazon gift cards, it's like the world is open to you because you never know where you're going to get. Me? All right, this is for a big, comfy, cozy, wearable blanket.
Here we go.
Come on, Zach.
Tolly Weiss.
Here you go.
I
love how you got to off with your pillow.
Okay, this is for it's a wooden puzzle craft. It's like 600 pieces of a 3D something you put together, and then it does something. It's cool. It's a puzzle box, a treasure box. Philo! Woo! Yeah. This is for the lava lamp. Nice big lava lamp for that retro vibe. Huge lava lamp.
Caleb Gutstein!
Excellent. Here, okay. This is for the waffle maker. It's a little mini personal waffle maker.
Zach Miller again.
Wait, no. Zach Miller won something? Yeah, sorry, buddy. No waffles for you. That's why I put them all out here.
Arach Arnold.
Woo! Alright, and this is, you would think last but not least, but this is for the AirPods with the wireless charging case. Again, a very full jar. No, I have a... Everyone's telling me that this is the last raffle. However, I have a secret surprise bonus raffle that we're gonna do. Try again. All right. Oh, what? That person put a lot of tickets in. They're all Tali. She just pulled her name twice.
Fair. Nava Dreitzer.
I'm dumping all the tickets into one more box. When I say I mean my evil assistant. And we're going to pull one more raffle. Can you just help her dump the rest in so it goes fast? Here, bring the... And this is actually, the raffle is for the watermelon squishy. I didn't bring it outside, so after we pull the raffle, I'll just hand it to whoever it is that wins. Okay? Here, I just throw a few more in there. Just shake it up. It's a very scientific method. It's kind of like how I cook. Alright, let's see. Zach, this is a big one. He's not looking. He's not cheating.
He cheated.
Someone who already won a prize, sorry. Somebody who
already won a prize. It's a lot of people winning prizes. Who was going home with the squishy?
Reva!
Nope, not her.
Not her.
He's just looking at the screen. Jack Copeland.
It's on video.
Okay. If you got the ice cream maker, it's right here. Come collect.
Now we'll take a moment for something a little more serious. We'll take a moment to remember Eric Berkovich. We're about the time of his sixth yard site. Eric was one of the first teens to ever attend Cteen years ago. And when he finished high school, he made Aliyah to serve in the Israeli army. And tragically, he passed away shortly after arriving in Israel. Tehei Zichrei Baruch, may his memory be a blessing for all of us. This is Cteen. And so every single teen present will be recognized tonight. We're going to present each and every teen here with a gift of a Cteen bag, which hopefully will be arriving on the podium momentarily. Let's do something. Let's travel. Let's go somewhere this summer. And Cteeners, there are Shabbatones and camping trips and good times in your future. And this bag will be perfect for you. Now I have the opportunity to talk in a tone of voice as if I was reading, but really I'm ad-libbing. That's because the gifts we need to distribute aren't present here on the podium. However, they are present in existence, just not in this moment of time, in this sphere of existence. However, our able-bodied Cteen mascot, using machinery engineered by Jack Copeland, imagined by Ronen Lavi, and powered by Jesse Goldberg, will convey the bags here in a very short period of time. Actually, it won't be much time at all. It'll be in about 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you, all right. And so what's gonna happen is, look at me when I talk. What's gonna happen is, I'm gonna call up every single Cteener by name, Cteen and Cteen Junior. You'll come up to this side of the stage, on this side, which is my left, right, this side. Yona will hand you the gift, you come along behind us, and stay over here by this black car. Because when it's over, we're taking a group picture. And we need everyone to stay there because this will be the biggest group picture ever of Skokie Cteen history. We need everyone's help for that.
Skokie Cteen! Skokie Cteen!
This also is the night that we break our first mic.
No.
But don't worry, they have more mics on Kimberly. It's not a problem. Yeah. All right, so. Yona, you ready? Okay, Elizabeth Abrams! Step right up. Okay, and Rachel Adar! And Baruch Arnold! And Nathaniel Azula! And Julia Benditson and Amanda Bland. And Hannah Kantz. Come up on this side and stay over here by the black car. And Anna Copeland. And Jack Copeland. Walk right around. And Maayan Dalal. And Jesse Goldberg. And Zachary Goldberg. And Haley Galtz. Where's Haley? And Caleb Gutstein. Kobe Harris. Joseph Hunt, who came here all the way from Israel just to be here tonight. Racheli Kramer. Ronen Lavi. Rotem Lavi. Philip Maimon. Zoe Matanky. Zach Miller. Ethan Moratti. Rami Ripstein. Noah Rosenberg. Kara Rosenberg with a U. Adi Saruya. Avi Saruya. Nachshon Strimling. Tehila Wiener. Eli Weiss. Elon Blumenthal. Riva Weiss. Ariel Yitzhaki. Yoshua Zagorin. And now for Cteen Junior, Leah Ackerman. Elon Copeland. Emily Darlow. Nava Draitzer. Simona Friedberg.
There's my boy. I don't forget you.
Abigail Reeses. Maddie Galtz. Parker Gradstein. Archer Gradstein. Eyal Gutstein. Aaron Hartman. Maddie Jacobson. I read those names too fast. That's why I wasn't hired for a graduation. My timing is off. But don't worry, we got this. We'll take it easy and we'll catch up. And it's all gonna be hunky-dory. I charge for my jokes. It wasn't included in the contract. Professional standards. Ella Cacone. Abraham Kramer. Cteen mascot.
Watch your step.
Sarah Leonard.
Hold your tummy.
Eliana Levine. She's not here, right? Sarah Lipson. Shmuley Loiterman. Levi Madoff. Ori Moore. Yuval Moore. Shalom Posner. Jacob Rappaport. There was one name before that was misspelled and I ad-libbed it and I think I left somebody out based on how I did that. So I apologize. I'm asking that person, please don't feel bad. I tried to fix it and I made a bigger mistake. I'm sorry about that. Please come up. When we're done and someone left, I'm really sorry. Abigail Reeses, I already called, right? So that's not called her twice. I didn't call Abigail? Okay, Abigail Reeses. Romy Sarbajil. Ella Tag. Avi Tropy. Ami Weiss. Are there any teens left in this crowd? If you weren't called and you have the guts to say me, I'll admire you forever. Now, you know what? It was a Goldberg. I confused that. That's what. I saw Abigail and Abigail. My brain went crazy. She's already graduated. Okay, so Abby Goldberg. And now we're gonna call up the Cteen alum. Now Cteen alum, don't get gifts because you're too big for gifts, but we want you in the picture and we recognize you. So Rachel Goldberg, Haley Jakovsky, Levi Kramer, Jared Stein, and the real chaperone, the alum bud, Kyle Verson. Let's gather together for the record-breaking Cteen picture.
Skokie! 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 Come on, guys.
My back is dying. Everyone put up your Cteens right here.
Now a crazy one.
Why are they shining lights?
Should you crazy? Yeah, crazy.
We're good.
Stay there, don't go anywhere.